So I think all I said there. So I am Professor Dr. Vivek Gupta, and I am Senior Consultant Cardiologist in Apollo Hospital, Delhi. We are starting this live webinar of IECR, which is Indo-European course on revascularization. I will share the screen first to show what it is about. And this is, I think you are able to see the screen. Can you see the screen now?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So this is the program which we have started today. And this is COVID-19 pandemic. We all are suffering for last almost 6 months now. Started with Wuhan in China. So I am Dr. Vivek Gupta. Then we have Dr. Aman, Agarwal, Director, Professor of Finance, Indian Institute of Finance, New Delhi. Good friend of ours. He'll speak about some education as well. And then we'll have Mrs. Renu, Singh, who is the principal, Amity International, Noida. And we have close relationship with Mr. Chauhan. And also, our children have also studied in all these in this school. Mrs. Vandana, Kapoor is the principal of SLS DAV School, Mausam, Vihar, New Delhi. And she is very interested, and she wanted, and we all wanted to have an impact on school education, some webinar. Mr. Barthwal, a close friend, he is the principal in DAV School, Jasola. Dr. Yashpal, Sharma is a very good friend from Chandigarh, PGI. He's a cardiologist. He will give some update. Mrs. Pallavi Gupta, she is assistant of Amity University taking classes. And Mr. Pankaj, Jeswani, he is a celebrity singer. He will sing one or two songs before and after. Mr. Kedar Burande, I spoke to him just now. He was initially planning to come. He might still join in about 7:30. He is a PS to Minister of State for HRD. Mr. Sanjay Gotre Sahab. So let us see whether he will be able to join or not. So I will now stop sharing this screen. Start sharing the screen of this. I will, I think, mute everybody so that I will mute everybody. So, and I will unmute only those people whenever we are interested to talk to somebody. Okay. So let me just again unmute. Just say hello, Mr. Aman. Please say hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mrs. Vanda Kapoor, please say hello to everybody. Namaskar. Mr. Barthwal, are you able to see me? Namaskar. Then then Dr. Yashpal Sharma is, I think, busy on telephone. And I would like to see Mrs. Renu. I think she is not there. So I will start my lecture and then we'll take them later on. So let me start sharing my screen. And so I'll start my screen to giving the thought process about this virus. So okay. So one person I'll unmute so that I can just keep discussing with somebody. And that will be Mr. Aman, Mrs. Vanda ji, I will unmute you. So if there is anything wrong, so you can speak to me, and also Mr. Aman. Okay, so I'm starting my presentation. We are already very late. Eh? So today's perspective, May 25, global perspective is that this virus is not abating. The world is worried. WHO is worried, Donald Trump is worried, our Prime Minister is worried, we all are worried, doctors are worried, and the virus is not planning to go. I just gave a video for some TV news item just before starting this, and there is some news today that this heat may kill the virus. But this is not true. This is news which came from CDC. But today temperature is about 46 degrees centigrade in Delhi, and we are seeing every day rise of 4,000 to 5,000. We are testing less despite that we are. So today's perspective is more than 55.5 million people are affected all over the world. 3.4 lakhs deaths all over the world. In India, we are safer. Only 1,39,000 infected and 4,000 deaths. I'm comparing to other countries. Otherwise, 4,000 deaths is also a very important perspective. The American perspective I'm not going to take. Economic burden is causing a huge economic burden. More than 2 lakh crore package has been given and it has been distributed very well. This was recently, 5 days back. So I'm not going to detail. This is the economist, Mr. Angel Duria, speaking to France 24. I think this Mr. Aman Agarwal will tell a little later about this. So we all are using PPE. When are we doing angiography? The protocol in hospital is that we have to actually wear face shield, mask and everything. And this is the angioplasty done by me recently. This is a virus disease. And just to give introduction to the students, and also the SARS-CoV-2 virus is the third strain of the MERS, and then SARS, this is coronavirus strain 3, but this is known as COVID-2 virus because and COVID-19 because started in 2019. This initially present with antigen, and later on we have a cellular immunity and humoral immunity which give rise to antibodies. And let me tell you, today we had a patient in Apollo Hospital. We were trying to do plasma treatment and his antibodies were missing. So this virus is very intriguing that despite the patient who has recovered, there was a problem that the antibodies are not enough to protect him and he is already recovered. Corona S protein has been reported as significant determinant of virus entry into the host cells. This is a little medical core complicated, but it's important to understand the vaccine, which I'll come later on. After the virus enters the cell, the viral RNA genome is released into the cytoplasm and is translated to 2 polyproteins and structural proteins, after which the virus genome is done. We all know that virus is such a small in nanogram. The virus, the whole virus, which is in nanogram, is affecting the whole system. And this virus is considered to be living. And some people, they call it non-living because this is a protein. It does not require oxygen for its replication. Some, there is a debate whether this is a living thing, but it's a living thing. We all know virus and bacteria are not a non-living thing. When the virus enters the cell, its antigen will be presented to antigen presentation cells, which is central part of body antiviral immunity. So immunity has to be developed. What is cellular and humoral immunity? That depends upon IgM antibody and IgG antibody. Not going to the details, but IgM and IgG antibodies, initially IgM antibodies, they disappear by the end of 12 weeks, and then the IgG antibody can last for a longer time. The importance of IgG and IgM antibody is to diagnose with the help of the blood test. I will let you know later. The ARDS is the cytokine storm, is the last thing. We have lost so many patients all over the world. Recently, we lost, you must have read in the newspaper, a very senior pulmonologist from All India Institute. We are losing patients in Apollo. In Apollo, we have more than 81 patients reserved for this coronavirus, and we are treating other people. So cytokine storm will trigger a violent attack by the immune system, causing acute respiratory distress syndrome and multi-organ failure. So diagnosis is dependent basically upon the cough, fever, and dyspnea. We all know the cough, fever, and dyspnea is an important part. But let me tell you that epidemiological history, that means history of travel, clinical manifestations, CT scan, they all will help in diagnosis. The test which is done by, you know, RT-PCR test. Yeah, we are all reading in the newspaper. In fact, the media has made us very intelligent. But give me tell you that RT-PCR test is a basically quantitative polymerase chain reaction test. And this is done from the respiratory infection, respiratory secretions. It is not the blood test. It takes about 50 minimum 8 hours to 24 hours for the diagnosis to come. And this is the main cause. Initially, the cost was very high. We had little kit. Now we are testing about more than 1500 per million. At the same time, radiological diagnosis is made with the help of CT scan, because many times there is a false negative rate. Lot of people do not know that RT-PCR test is a very specific test, but many times you have a classical symptom and the patient will still be having a COVID and the test is normal. Then we do the CT scan, and CT scan is a very important diagnostic test which will help a ground glass appearance, a radiological diagnosis done with the help of this. Testing is key to success. PCR test, I was telling, is a test taken from throat secretion. It is not a blood test. While antibody test is a blood test which is done with the help of blood. NIV Pune has developed National Institute of Virus. Pune has developed India's first COVID-19 antibody kit. And this is going to be very useful. And sorry, you're able to see this. This is going to be, especially in those cases, Niti Aayog has planned to make India COVID testing superpower with the private help. They are planning to do a 1.25 lakh RT-PCR test, but this is not happening as of now. This was the planning on 9th of May. So testing involves bringing scientists and laboratories in touch with the private firms, but this is not free of cost. The test costs about 4,000 rupees or 5,000 rupees in the private setup. In the government setup, this is free. So testing with the rapid antibody test from China, you must have read in the newspaper, was found to be faulty. Therefore, now we are not able to do this testing, and we are dependent upon the antibody test coming from Singapore and also NIV, where we are in the Pune. We are waiting for that kit to come. How medicines work? As of now, there is no medicine which will be actually killing the virus. This is very important to tell you that there is no medicine which can kill the virus today. The virus enters the cell. It goes into the cell, they form RNA, polypeptide, non-structural protein, antigen-dependent protein, and then, of course, you have to... This is the place where hydroxychloroquine works, and this is the place where antiviral medicines are working. But today, as of today, there is not even a single drug which can be useful. Coming on to the hydroxychloroquine, everybody talking about hydroxychloroquine as prevention, and there have been so much multiple reports. Initially, let me go from starting from February. In February, the prophylaxis, it was clear that prophylaxis for the healthcare workers, hydroxychloroquine can be used. And there was a guideline from Indian Council of Medical Research in March that all the healthcare worker means doctors, nurses, ward boys, delivery boys, pharmacy boys inside the hospital should take hydroxychloroquine only one day and then every week, twice a day. This was a clear-cut guideline coming from Indian Council of Medical Research. Let me tell you, in February 2020, when China first reported that hydroxychloroquine is useful, there was a professor, Roroy, from Marcy. So let me translate. What he's saying is that he was laughing on this medicine. He said, this is not useful medicine and therefore you have to be careful and therefore you cannot use this medicine because this is cardiotoxic. But later on, he did a study and which was published on April 9, 1,000 patients, and they said that this is no cardiac toxicity. That is not is useful. It is not major cardiac toxicity. Useful in 91% patients. Death is only in 0.47% patients. This was done and this was April. Then later on, I would like to tell you, China had published a study in February and they said in the absence of any medicine, hydroxychloroquine should be used in the treatment as well as for prevention. But later on, FDA, which is American guideline, FDA, Federal Drug Administration, 28th March, they raised some doubt. But when they raised some doubt, then at that time, they were not very sure whether they will be able to use it or not. But they said emergency use authorization. When there is no other medicine which can be useful, this can be used for this. April 25, again, they made a guideline that this should be used. So today, as of now in India, in Apollo Hospital, all over the world, hydroxychloroquine is being used. And you remember so much of news made by Mr. Donald Trump. He came in February 24 to India with all delegation. At that time also coronavirus was there, but nobody thought that this is going to be pandemic. It was great. Pandemic was announced in March. March 24, our Honorable Prime Minister announced a lockdown. 22nd March, we all know this. That is the history now going. We are running in May now. So as of today, when Mr. Donald Trump was looking for hydroxychloroquine, our Prime Minister obliged him and they exported a lot of hydroxychloroquine to them. But today there is some data coming from Lancet. I'm telling you that this medicine may be harmful. But I personally believe as a competent person, as a cardiologist, that this medicine is very useful. And this is the only medicine which can be as of now. Coming to other medicine, what do you mean by repurposed medicine? Repurposed medicine, you're reading in the newspaper. Let me give you an example. Repurposed medicine means any medicine which is being used for some other purpose can be used and can be tried without showing its antiviral activity. My father, Dr. M.L. Gupta, you can see his photograph here. He has proposed, he is a very important researcher with Indian Council of Medical Research. he has proposed a new repurposed medicine which is being used for some other purpose to the Indian Council of Medical Research, directly writing to PMO. And since he is at this age also, he has given a protocol of 14 days trial. This is still to be approved by PMO and Indian Council of Medical Research. So what we are thinking is that we can use some medicine which is being used for some other purpose. It may be useful for this coronavirus because vaccine is still 12 months away. Let me tell you, minimum 6 months. So this is a drug which has been proposed by my father. Ivermectin, you must have used a few days back. You must have seen a news coming from Bangladesh. A country like Bangladesh, this ivermectin is an anti-protozoal medicine which is being used for protozoa and helminthic. That means the when you have worms in the stomach, it is FDA approved. This is the only medicine in vitro which has shown antiviral activity to the extent of 5,000-fold reduction of RNA. In vitro means inside the lab, not in the human beings as of now. As of now, not in the human beings. So let me tell you that this is going to be useful if it is just the human trial. Human trials are being done in USA, but no report as of now in India. So as of now, we are not dependent. Remdesivir is the only antiviral medicine which is approved by FDA, and we are still not having you. This is not available in India as of now. This is a patented drug. We are using other antiviral medicines, but this is one promising medicine. Coming on to the mask, before coming on to the general public now, that was more of a cardiology, more of a medical use of mask. As we all know that mask is very useful. There are two types of mask. One is N95, another is 3-ply mask. In fact, the television is telling every day. Let me show you one TV clip which I had done on March 26. And this is what I spoke on that day. So this is what I spoke. So what I am telling on 26 March is that everybody should use mask or hanky. Then what I spoke on 29th March on TV. So what I'm telling you is that on 26 March and on 29th March, there were no guidelines for people to wear mask or hanky outside the homes. Only healthcare workers were told. So we were a little late in that way, but I was thinking on 26 March and 29 March, when there was an Anand Vihar problem. You everybody knows that there were a lot of migrant workers. They came in Anand Vihar. That is the day. I spoke that Angocha can be used. Later on, our Honorable Prime Minister himself used Gamcha, and now that become a guideline for everybody. Let me tell you that we sometimes as a doctor, we also think in advance. So I gave this guideline that Angocha can be used. This is what I spoke on this television. Coming on to the vaccine. So what I mean to say today guideline is that everybody should be wearing something or the other on the face to cover the face. So coming on to the vaccine. Vaccine, this is a long-term planning. How the vaccine is made. This is what I want to show you. The vaccine is made through the antigen. You make a protein, you inject inside the body, you stimulate the body to develop antibodies, and these antibodies will be useful to protect you whenever you are exposed. So there are too many medicines coming up. More than 70 vaccines are being tested all over the world. WHO yesterday also said that it will take more than 12 to 18 months. A few vaccines have shown importance. The few vaccines which have shown importance are Moderna vaccine, which you must have read recently that they have finished the first human trial. There will be 3 human trials. And this is one vaccine which may come by the end of the year. Novavax vaccine, Evimeo vaccine, China. Pfizer is making one vaccine. Johnson & Johnson, this is Chinese, which is making one vaccine. Beijing, University of Oxford was the first to start the human trial. But considering that this vaccine will never come before the end of this year in the market, whether it will be useful or not, because I will tell you one example where Mr. Boris Johnson, I take him a very important, interesting, because he himself has suffered from this. Italian scientists have made some vaccine, which is again, which may come a little faster. But the Israel has proposed one vaccine I will show you later on, because these are not so important for you to understand. Israel has based a monoclonal antibodies, which is a treatment like plasma treatment. That means you infuse the patient and the patient will be cured, almost cured. So what happens if the vaccine does not come at all? This was a news day before yesterday all, because there are a lot of diseases where we don't have vaccine. For example, HIV. HIV vaccine is still not made, but we have a treatment for it as well. Boris Johnson made that could vaccine be more than a year away. Johnson has warned that in worst cases, scenario, vaccine may never be found. In that case, we have to really depend upon some medicine. For example, for HIV, we have a medicine now, patient can live long. Contact tracing, role of Aarogya Setu app. I think many people understand, many people don't understand. Let me still tell you what is contact tracing. There's an app by Aarogya Setu, which you can download on your mobile. When you are in contact with somebody during last 14 days, the mobile will give you a signal, and that signal will be, that means you have to now quarantine yourself. So one should not worry about, because Ministry of Telecommunication and Electronic Department, they have given guidelines that this may not be taking your data. So there was some privacy issue. I'm not going to details. Plasma treatment. Today only I had a patient in Apollo Hospital who's requiring plasma treatment. So what is plasma treatment? Plasma treatment is still investigational, to be used only in the patients who are very sick on ventilator. You take out the blood from the patient who is suffering, and when the patient is suffering, you take the blood out, take the plasma, infuse the antibody to the patient, and the patient should improve. But it has not shown promise as of today. Even despite plasma treatment, patient has died. I'm not here to create panic, but I'm here to tell you that we have to take precautions. Herd immunity. Stockholm was the first country, Sweden. Stockholm, they did not do lockdown. What is herd immunity? Herd immunity means everybody is allowed to be infected, few will die, few will survive, and everybody will have immunity. This is known as herd immunity. But this is not going to work in this case, coronavirus disease. The reason is that this has a high mortality of 5%. Patients who are heart disease will die 15%. Patients who are 80 years old, 20% patient will die. So lockdown is the answer. Herd immunity is not the answer. This is my say. But as of today, this is a news coming from China. This is the Great Wall of China. I have been to the Great Wall of China. I have seen many times. And this is nice place. Now they have stopped. They have stopped the lockdown. And everybody is allowed. They are possibly thinking that people may have herd immunity. Something is better than nothing. But I don't believe in that. I personally feel we had a webinar with a cardiologist from Europe. They all said herd immunity should not be used, and lockdown has to continue. Day before yesterday, I was on television because the lockdown has come down. Although Honorable Prime Minister has turned the lockdown till 31st of May, but still most of the chief ministers are trying to ease out the lockdown. But lockdown, the study by the Indian population of the International Institute of Population Sciences has shown that the COVID number could have been 30 lakhs without lockdown. It could have been more than 1.71 crore all over the world. So lockdown is important. So how India is preparing? India is preparing with a lot of oxygen. ICUs are being prepared. And today you must have read in the newspaper, Mr. Kejriwal wants that all the private hospitals should be having the beds. All the hospitals. Earlier there were only dedicated hospitals like Apollo and Max and like that, but now they want this. Ventilator treatment is very important. Let me tell you, there is still a lot of news coming in the media, not today, but at least 1 year back, especially when there was something like Satyamev Jayate, one of the stars. He made one program and he abused ventilator treatment. He said it's a money-making machine. Today we know that ventilator is actually a life-saving machine. Many district hospitals do not have ventilator. Italy fell short of ventilator. America fell short of ventilator. So when I used to hear about something like that, again, something that this is something for the private hospitals, let me tell you, this is where oxygen, when the oxygen is finished inside the body, when there is so much of lung trauma, oxygen cannot, then you have to put the ventilator. We do ventilator every day and we remove it. Of course, one should not abuse it. Ventilator is life-saving. Healthcare workers. Many patients are dying all over the world. This is a nurse who was talking. is the BBC World News. So I was telling that healthcare workers are the worst affected. When Mr. Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, he announced that clapping should be done, I completely agree. We have a corona ICU. I sometimes fear myself. I wear the mask. I wear the PPE kit. I feel that sometimes I should not go. When I come to Apollo, my family does not allow me to come because this is a virus. It's not going to, we have to live with it. Everybody knows it. So we should really salute the nurses especially who are working inside the coronavirus isolation ICU. They are putting the RAS tube. They are putting the IV line. They are most vulnerable. Coronavirus plasma treatment, I have told you that plasma therapy is antibody therapy. Role of China, I'm not going to tell you. Everybody knows something is there. But one of the professor, Hansu Konju, who is a co-awardee of Nobel Prize, he said in a news item, which later on turned out to be fake news or whether he made a U-turn, we don't know, that he said this is a human-made virus and my Nobel Prize may be returned. I will return it back if it has turned out to be non-true. But today we know that China is trying to cooperate and China says that perhaps they are ready to cooperate in finding out the origin of this deadly virus, which is the worst pandemic after Spanish flu, which happened in early 1909, when our Mahatma Gandhi was also affected. More than 6 crore population vanished at that time. So we are not sure how many people will die with this COVID. I'm not there to scare you, but I want to tell you and warn you, according to our Prime Minister, two P, one is precaution, another P is, of course, don't panic. Don't panic, but take care of yourself and heart. Coming on to the last part of my talk, this is the last slide which I want to present to you, that overall mortality, that was February 24, is 2.3%. Overall mortality is 2.3%, but with cardiovascular disease is 10%, patient more than 80 years, 15%, with diabetes, 7%. That means those who have comorbidity, they have a higher risk. The last thing, Prof, we'll take some questions later on. The patient, the pregnant mother, if they have pregnant mother, we have now whether the children born to the pregnant mother who is COVID positive, they are found to be antibody positive, but they are not infected. Thank you very much for this presentation of mine. I take my share screen off and then I take myself out. And I think I have given a little longer presentation, but this was just to introduce to a lot of people who are hearing. And from the sequence, I will go and introduce to, I think, Mr. Aman will like to speak, and then we will have Mr. Renu Singh, and then Mrs. Vandana Kapoor, who has actually initiated the whole program. And then we will see other people to speak, Dr. Yashpal Sharma. So, where, Mr. Aman, would you like to speak now? So, Mr. Aman Agarwal, let me introduce again. But before that, I wanted to introduce one of my friend who is a singer. I think I forgot to introduce him because of my little delayed starting, Mr. Jeswani. So, Mr. Jeswani, you start something you wanted to speak before, then I will go to Mr. Aman Agarwal. Mr. Jeswani?
Sir, unmute kijiye in logon ko. Sir, in logon ko unmute kijiye.
I'm trying to unmute him, but I think his figure is fixed. He's not able to hear. Okay, let me go to Mr. Aman Agarwal, who is a very important friend and very important speaker. He's a director of Indian Institute of Finance and is a professor. And then we will go to Mr. It's difficult to find. It's not easy because I'm there alone. Mr. Aman, can you see me?
Sir, you have to unmute Mr. Agarwal. Sir, you have to unmute him.
I think I will allow unmuting to everybody so that anybody, the participant, can also unmute themselves. So that will be easy.
Yes, thank you.
So you have unmuted yourself, but I cannot see your photo. I have to take you on the panel.
Okay, should I, maybe you have to set the spotlight, maybe that could be the reason. Are you able to see me?
Not yet, we are starting you.
Yeah, namaskar. Are you able to see me now?
Yes, okay. Please go ahead.
Namaskar. Thank you for that introduction, Dr. Verma. I think you gave a beautiful presentation on...
Vivek Gupta, not Verma.
No, I said Dr. Gupta.
Yes, okay.
Thank you, Dr. Gupta, for giving all of us this beautiful presentation on the COVID scenario. I think you listed out everything which has been discussed to a great extent. Although I would like to add that I don't know how far it is true, but then the IIT Madras with Japan is working on the Ayurvedic structure of using ashwagandha as building up the immunity factor. I don't know, you are a doctor, you would know better. But as you asked me to speak, I would like to give you a brief input on what we have been doing from an economic perspective and specifically on the impact of school education, which you outlined beautifully as a topic for today. You know, one thing before I begin on the impact of school education, I would like to point out to the panelists, I spoke on the economics of pandemic, and while working it out and for almost 4 months now at the Institute, we are trying to do research on what's been going on and what are the economic impacts and what can happen. And to my surprise, and in fact, to our surprise, we found that when we studied a pandemic situation, which have taken place almost in a span of 3,000 years, almost about 22, 24 major pandemics have taken place in the last 3,000 years. Some of them have been in such a bad state that it was declared, like in the one in Tunisia, like in Europe, and then even SARS, the Spanish flu, it was declared that this is the end of world. Whereas we all are working here, living, talking to each other. So let us be very clear about one fact, as Dr. Gupta also said, that there is no end of world. There is life, and there is life with COVID, which is supposed to be there going forward from now on. The other thing which was a surprise was that when we studied these scenarios, and we studied these scenarios, we studied other scenarios like tsunami, wars which have taken place, whether it is man-made disasters which have taken place, burnings of forests, burnings of land, tsunamis which have taken place. And again, as I said, not from a humanitarian point of view, but from a economic standpoint, from a financial standpoint, it was surprising to note that most of these cases, whenever these things have happened, economies have rebounded back within a span of 6 months to a year within the last 200 years of most of these situations which have happened. Whether it is 2004 tsunami which took place, or whether it is other scenarios which took place, we have seen that there has been a rebound factor of almost about 6 months to a year. And that is important from my own perspective and consideration, because today, large amount of the population, business community, small traders, individuals are worried about the fact, what is going to happen to me tomorrow? Am I going to survive? Am I going to work? Am I going to have revenue tomorrow or not? And there are a large number of factors. It's not the forum to discuss the economic issues, but I thought I must point out these two points before I begin my talk on the issue of impact on school education, which is a key factor which has been outlined here. I think I have more prominent people and more people who are dealing with primary school education in specific, but then I will still outline what I have been noticing and we have been trying to do being an educator myself. I think it's important that the school education is going to evolve. As I say, this whole market mechanism which is going through a shift now because of the COVID, going through an evolution process. Old market mechanism structures will get demolished, new ones will come in. Some of them, the older ones will pre-exist, but new ones will come in. Today I see doctors giving consultation online extensively. One of my friend's daughter, who is a psychiatrist in New York, she says she is more busy now during the COVID period than she was before as a doctor. She ends up spending more time discussing with her parent, and everything is confidential. And it is more easy, more communicable. It's more revenue generating for her as well. But that's not the revenue part which she's looking at, but the way she's able to help the community at large. I have been organizing this large sequence of Eminence of Life and Growth series, and I've been interviewing almost about 45, 50 people across the globe. And my understanding that people have actually benefited from some of these phases of lockdowns around the world, in this sense that they have come close to the families, mental acceptability, touching hearts with each other. The quote which comes out from the Buddhist monk, which says, stop running, very important. We need to stop running. We need to rethink. We need to re-meditate, whether it is spiritually, not religiously, whether it is spiritually, self-consciously, we need to do that. I think that introspection has gone across the globe, whether it is a question of parents, whether it is a question of students, children studying in colleges or schools, or even at a primary level. the assignments which are given lately to children, I'm very happy to see some of them, where the small children are told to go and work with their parents, arrange things, sort out things, help mothers in kitchen. Very important aspect. I, as a child, was always doing that when I was a child, because we did not have so many sources of entertainment, hardly any television, hardly anything except for going to the grounds. So we did have time for the playground, but the children have got locked down to either studying or being in front of the video or the television. That is something which, is, in my opinion, is fairly coming as unique in terms of a new education framework. I remember when I was being interviewed by a couple of times by Rajya Sabha Television, I was told by one of the anchors that he has gone in for a homeschooling, wherein he is not sending his child to school. Another friend of mine in the US, he's there looking at community living, where they're not sending their children anymore to schools. It is community teaching which is taking place and educating them, then they take an exam and go forward for universities and all. Now, there was already taking place. But this particular framework which has come in place now is going to rethink educators, institutions. What can they do? How can they service more? These channels which have come up, which Government of India has launched, amazing product, 12 channels. One another additional to that, disabled channels for educating. I think that will end up bridging the gap between rural India and urban India to a great extent. But then, as one of my guests which spoke, who was former Secretary of Defense, Government of India, and also has been a student of our institute, she said that how many people have access to internet? How many people have access to television? And that's what government needs to also think about when introducing some of these panels. You know, the parents are troubled. Schools have introduced online education, giving lectures one after the other. Teachers are working very hard, disseminating information. But then how many people can really capture that? How many parents have so many multiple mobiles, 2, 3, 4 children? How many can they give access to multiple classes? So I think it is a question. It is still an evolution process. Schools, institutions have to re-understand as to what it will be. My 5 hours teaching in a college, in the institute, one after the other, is easier as against 5 hours of lectures being given on an online display or a framework. And that is something which schools and educational institutions need to take into consideration. Another important factor is already students are exposed to frameworks. As parents' engagements, they want to push them to digital frameworks. So I was saying that when there is a different space which is given, where in terms of television, in terms of playing, in terms of communicating with friends, in terms of interacting of different levels of children in school education, even at going to graduation and post-graduation, and even below, I think these institutions need to think of how many hours of inputs are we wanting to give to the students? How much hours of display time are we wanting to give? Every day I read in newspapers, people working from home, getting mental illness, depressions, because and tired because of display time. I think it's important that schools think about the fact how much they're doing. And I would say only 2 more components before I take a break for others to speak as well, Dr. Gupta, if you allow me, is the fact that, you see, we need to look at the fact that most women today are working. So they have now 4 duties to take care of. One is they have to take care of their work offices. Second, they have to take care of home chores. Third, they have to take care of the children or the elderly in the family. And fourth, they have to now tutor their young children, especially children who are between the age bracket of 3 years to at least about 10 or 12 years. Beyond that, children can still adopt the technology. But prior to that, they have to. Now, it is an added work and workload which has been given onto them, which is not possible for immediately to people. I think it's important that schools think about it, regulate it, structure it in such a manner that it becomes a little more easier for the people who are under lockdown in structures to go about inhabiting, so that there is an appropriate amount of education and learning which can take place. One important component is that there must be a structure like in school, where you have PT periods, where you have periods for science, where you have people period for lab, where you have interactions, music, culture. Similarly, the program which most educational institutions are devising today are missing some of these components. And I think that needs to be calibrated into the factor so that the children get evolved, get structure themselves, interact. I don't think social distancing would be such a key important factor. In India, we have been observing large number of norms which have been told out by WHO. The immunity factor in India, as I've been saying, has been fairly high. I have friends, as you rightly mentioned, sir, Dr. Gupta, about Sweden. Large number of friends there, one or two of them who are not ill, prominent CEOs of companies, they are saying, it's better if I get a COVID because I would get over it. I think it's important to question, to have a positive attitude. We have, some of the doctors I have spoken from AIIMS and other places, they told me that COVID has existed for almost over 2000 years in different forms. If it has existed, then it will exist tomorrow. Let us learn to live with it. We need to breathe with it. We need to grow with it, not be fearful of it. When we fear, I remember this quote from Ramayana when, you know, when Ram was there and there was this Hanuman's Varnasena was there, the whole process was that the person will get half the energy. There was a fear factor. Rama, there was a fear factor created. Half of your energy, half of your strength goes away because of fear. Dr. Gupta is a better judge of it. If you're positive in mind, if you have that zeal inside you, I think you can win over. As it jokingly say, a woman at the dying bed said, told, oh, there is a sale taking place. She will get up from the bed. Another story I heard was the other day of a real story of a grandmother who was ill. The nurse, she was about to die, but then her grandchildren came and said, we want some food and chapati from your hand. She got up from the bed. She went to the kitchen, cooked, and she was perfectly fine. The nurse was very happy and surprised to see this. I think it's a question of that positivity. Lockdown has given us time to introspect, to rethink about it. But the question is, are we going towards the positive mind frame or not? If we are not, we need to start thinking positive, pinning down things and getting on the job. I'd like to thank Dr. Gupta to have given me this opportunity. I would like others to speak now because, as I said, primary education, you have more experts there. But I thought I should pen down this point. And my dear friend, you do not need to be worried. People say, I tell on television also so many times, almost every day, barber services will be required. I have not got a haircut done, nor large number of people have not got a haircut done. Immediately, they will rush to haircut barbers like the alcohol. This is a private service provider. Large number of people have not gone out. They would like, my wife has been wanting to just step out and say, I want to go around and take a walk with you and spend some time. People will start consuming. There will be heavy consumption. There will be inflation in the next 6 months because of heavy consumption as soon as this lockdown restraints and constraints are reduced. You need to have confidence. Take care of the hygiene factor. And I think nothing will happen if you have that confidence in you. Thank you, Dr. Gupta.
Thank you, Mr. Agarwal. You have given a very positive things, but I would add that precaution is still important because this is a more deadly virus. Okay, so it was very nice talking to you and listening to you. And if Madam Vandana Kapoor allows me, then I can take Mrs. Renu ji before. She had some meeting also. So let me take Mrs. Renu Singh, who is the principal of Amity International School, which is a very important school and important, well-known place. Can you start speaking about what are you planning to do in your school so that when the schools open up, children would not be worried, number one, and we should not be spreading the virus, if at all. Especially because you have not only children, but you have a lot of other people who are working in the school. What are your plans?
Okay, good evening to you all. And thank you, Dr. Gupta, for giving this wonderful opportunity to be with you all. Parents are also very scared and they are anxious what will happen when the school reopens. We are planning till now in the first week of July, but let's see what happens. Although we are getting ready, like we have prepared different teams and teachers are also preparing, as sir was saying, that we have already started online teaching, but actually this is not the replacement of classroom teaching, as he said correctly. Although we are trying to give wellness classes also, we are making sure that they are emotionally not disturbed, these children, but there's no replacement of classroom teaching, which I feel, although we are trying to finish a lot of syllabus online, cutting down on syllabus, They are also going to plan next academic session accordingly, because I don't know how many working days we are going to get as far as other practicals are concerned. I mean, CBS is looking into this, and Home Ministry is also planning to give us some guidelines how to go about it. But from our end, what we are doing, because we are all very anxious, we are all worried, we are making sure that all these things like sanitizers are enough, they are in different places. We will make sure that all the maids and everybody is having masks. Then we will keep, carefully that social distancing, although these things are not easy. Even if we call 33% children in one, time, I think we are planning to have 30% children for classroom teaching and rest online simultaneously. And then we replace, because children also are missing school. They also want to come back. So we are all trying to find out solution to this problem. And as you people are giving us information, we will make sure that we implement those things, those safety measures, and do something good for the children. All the prayers are there for everybody that we remain healthy, and this time shall also pass. Thank you, Dr. Gupta, for inviting me for this. Thank you very much.
I personally feel that, will you be letting all the children to wear the face mask, or what is the planning? I mean, something this has to be really planned with the education ministry and the district magistrate.
Yes, we are going to get some information from guidelines from CBSE and Ministry of Home Affairs. And we have already started preparing masks for the children. In our school, there is a department where we are preparing for children. We are also donating these masks and other material for the government school children also. So the planning is on, Dr. Gupta.
Okay, so thank you very much, Madam Renu. I would like you to stay back for some time at least, because there are other speakers, and Mrs. Pallavi Gupta is going to share some slides also. But before that, I think everybody has to stay. Dr. Yashpal Sharma is a friend from Chandigarh, but he will speak a little later on. He will coordinate later on. If Mr. Pankaj Jeswani wanted to say something, but his video is not working, I think. He said that he would like to sing a song before the thing starts, but I think he's not ready. So let me talk. Mr. Jeswani, are you ready? Would you like to sing a song just for the children? Because there are a lot of children who are listening to you. Yeah, a chota suna dijiye before, because we have to go for many speakers. कोई ऐसा ऐसा जो कि बच्चों को उत्साह दे, a very small one. He said we will like to sing before and then later on. This was his request, so I thought let us have it. Because there's
बच्चे आपके आपके किस किस age group के हैं?
बच्चे बच्चे मतलब starting from class 4 to class 12.
12.
We will be recording. It will go later on. A lot of people will hear this.
मैं दो चार लाइनें inspiring जो बच्चों के लिए हैं, वो सुना देता हूँ. हर बच्चा चाहता है, जो हर पेरेंट्स चाहते हैं, जो सीख देना चाहते हैं. एक मैंने गीत भी लिखा था, उसकी चार लाइनें पहले डॉक्टर साहब सुना देता हूँ आपको. सबसे पहले धन्यवाद करता हूँ मैं आपका, बीच में जुड़ा हूँ तो मैं पहले मेरा फर्ज बनता है डॉक्टर विवेक गुप्ता का धन्यवाद करूँ कि हमें भी याद करते हैं कलाकारों को. बहुत अच्छा कॉज लेके आ रहे हैं आप. एक बच्चों पर मैंने लिखी थी कविता, गीत कुछ भी कहते, मैं सारे सम्माननीय बैठे हैं स्कूलों के प्रिंसिपल्स और रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स. बच्चों बनो महान, तुम हो जग की शान. ऑडिबल सर, ठीक आ रहा है आवाज?
हाँ बिल्कुल ठीक है, ऑल गुड.
बच्चों बनो महान, तुम हो जग की शान, देश का ऊंचा नाम करो तुम, यही है अरमान. अब देखिए, जैसे बोए बीज हैं हमने वैसे ही फल पाएंगे. जैसे बोए बीज हैं हमने वैसे ही फल पाएंगे, उस पर बच्चे कदम बढ़ाते जो हम राह दिखाएंगे. जितनी अच्छी नींव हो उतना अच्छा बने मकान. जितनी अच्छी नींव हो उतना अच्छा बने मकान. बच्चों बनो महान, तुम हो जग की शान, देश का ऊंचा नाम करो, यही है अरमान. कहते हैं
नन्हे बच्चे तेरी मुट्ठी में क्या है, नन्हे मुन्ने बच्चे तेरी मुट्ठी में क्या है, मुट्ठी में है तकदीर हमारी, किस्मत को बस में किया है, नन्हे मुन्ने बच्चे तेरी मुट्ठी में क्या है। और ये भी कहते ना, पापा कहते हैं बड़ा नाम करेगा बेटा हमारा, ऐसा काम करेगा, मगर ये तो कोई न जाने, ये मेरी मंजिल है कहाँ, मगर ये तो कोई न जाने, ये मेरी मंजिल है कहाँ। पापा कहते हैं बड़ा नाम करेगा,
सबको अच्छा भी लगेगा, बच्चों को तो खास कर पसंद आएगा। और आप भी डॉक्टर साहब किशोर कुमार के फैन है मुझे मालूम है, तो छोटा सा गीत पेश करते हैं।
पल गई के पास रहती हो, पल गई के पास रहती हो, जीवन मीठी प्यार ये कहती हो, ये पल के पास रहती हो, तेरा चल लहराए हर रात यादों की, बारात ले आए मैं सांस लेता हूँ तेरी खुशबू आती है, एक महका महका सा राम लाती है, तेरे दिल की धड़कन भी तेरे गीत गाती है, अपने आंगन में
मिस्टर पंकज जेसवानी जी, बच्चों को उत्साह आ गया और हम लोग को भी आ गया है, तो या थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू सो मच। मिसेस वंदा कपूर जी वुड लाइक टू स्पीक नाउ, आफ्टर दैट आई टेक मिसेस पल्लवी गुप्ता एंड देन मिस्टर बर्थवाल एंड देन डॉक्टर यशपाल शर्मा एंड देन वी विल गेट बैक टू अदर पीपल एंड देन डॉक्टर हरीश शर्मा इज देयर फ्रॉम हॉलैंड, ही इज आल्सो वुड लाइक टू स्पीक समथिंग इन रिलेशन टू the health, what is going on in school education in Nederland. So Madam Vandana Kapoor, I would like to introduce, she is the principal of Mausam Vihar DAV, SLS DAV school, and very important person for all the Delhiites. Please go ahead, madam.
Very good evening, everyone. I'm delighted that I talked to Dr. Gupta and we came to this conclusion that we should conduct this program. Till I talked to you, Doctor, then I started collecting a lot of information. But before we go on to the salient features, which are very important to all of us, I would like to say that the schools are real temples of learning. They shape the destiny of nation. And school plays a pivotal role in the upbringing of character building of a child, and child's physical and emotional well-being is casted in real molds in learning temples that are our schools. And very, very disheartening that COVID-19, which is almost in 210 countries and 90% of the school students are not able to attend the school these days. This lockdown in itself is a situation which marks the basic concept of learning. Since we are in contact always, our academics for students don't work in isolation. Learning is an integral process of so many things. It is emotional wellness, physical well-being, social acceptance, art of speaking, art of understanding. It is a journey which a student and a teacher accomplishes together. A classroom is a laboratory where so many experiments are done in a day to make every student a jubilant human being, a person who is sensitive towards one and all. So this COVID-19, in perspective of this COVID-19, we have to redefine our teaching, we have to redefine our learning, and also we have to adopt safety protocols. As far as the redefining of teaching and learning is concerned, we are now rationalizing the curriculum in totality. Our teachers are teaching the classes for past 2 months beautifully online. We could conduct trainings for them, and they have adopted this online teaching learning process so beautifully, and they have motivated the students so nicely that they were able to even conduct the examinations. But now we have to divert ourselves from content learning to competency learning, because the time is less. We are losing on time. So we have to focus on competency and we have to remodulate our teaching learning process so that we are not too much dependent on content. It should be the teacher's motivation and the motivation of students. So this endeavor is now going to be collaborative examination in totality, and it will be a collaborative assimilation of knowledge. And for this, now we are diverting ourselves into blended learning, which will be very, very useful when we are going to reopen, because we will be partly working in the school and we will be partly working online. Am I audible?
Yes. Okay, go ahead, please.
So I was saying that we have to divert our teaching learning process from content-based teaching learning process to competency-based learning. And it is going to be a collaborative teaching learning process. So when we are going to reopen, as we expect, we have to make our teaching learning process blended teaching learning process. The learning time compensation, which is, that CBSC, the MHRD are examining right now, they are curating the syllabus. So this information also will come to us by end of June. So we have to upskill ourselves in such a way that we are able to conduct the online learning also, teaching learning process also, and we have to take up the direct teaching learning process also, which will be the students, maybe the 33% students come in one go, or the 50% students come on one day and the rest of the 50% students come on another day. And that also we have to see whether the parents will be willing to send the children in the beginning. And for that, we are pooling our resources. We are now taking the safety measures also into consideration. We are re-equipping ourselves, our schools in best possible manner, so that when the children start coming to school, they should be, not only we should be ready with the curating of the syllabus, we should also be ready with the curating of our resources, because now it is going to be digital versus face-to-face teaching. And we have to adopt the flip model. We have to depend on experiential learning. Even I was talking to Director Academics, Sir Dr. Emmanuel, and he said, even you have to get prepared yourself for the virtual practicals also. So our safety measures will affect the protocols, not only for academic, for practicals, and for physical well-being of the students in the school when they come to school, the physical well-being of the staff when the staff comes to school. So we have to redefine our teaching learning process. We have to now more go on to the aptitude of the children. We have to understand their feasibility of teaching learning process in the school, online, and then also our evaluation and assessment procedure also. So it's going to be pooling of resources which are available from MHRD, from CBSE, from other various resources. And we are pooling the resources which our teachers have prepared. They have done a wonderful job in the last 2 months. And this pooling of resources, rather CBSE is asking from us that we should share from all our fraternity. So now SOPs, some SOPs WHO has introduced. But now some SOPs for schools, Ayush, Ministry of Ayush, and Ministry of MHRD and CBSE, they have come together and they are pooling the resources to make SOPs particularly for the school education when the school have to start working. So now it is going to be new normal to be adopted. It's not to be the previous normal. The SOPs which we were working on, we have to adopt new normal working. So it's a total rejuvenation of school education, sir, because we are curating the syllabus because the time is short. Maybe the children come from August, maybe the children may not come till October, and that too partially. So we are adopting the blended learning. So we are curating not only syllabus, we are curating our safety measures. So the school has to have a new lease of life. And for that, this is the time we have already started preparing ourselves and our teams are working on it. My teachers have done a wonderful job in the last 2 months. And I think all school faculty is doing wonderful job on online teaching and online dissemination of knowledge. So it's... And the medical aspects, of course, you are the best guide. But for academic, we are once again on the new toes. So thank you very much for giving me such wonderful time. But I would like to tell you that these are very, very testing times for the school, sir. And we are trying to come up on the expectations of parents. We are trying to come up on the expectations of CBSE. We are trying to come up on the expectations of MHRD and all the other connected agencies. Thank you so much, sir. Shall I continue, sir? Dr. Gupta, am I audible?
Okay, so sorry that I was not, there was some video issue earlier, but later on it was corrected and we could see you very well all over. It is going on Facebook.
Was I audible, sir? not too loud?
Yes, perfectly, perfectly all audible.
The listening part is more important. Viewing is not that important.
My question, although both the children are now medical, one is doctor, other is medical student. My worry is if you recall that when we used to be a student, ourselves, Dr. Yashpal Sharma, Dr. Aman, Mr. Aman, and Dr. Hari Sharma will all agree. The course, the syllabus has gone up so much that actually it is too much of pressure. Now, this is a high time for CBSE and HRD department. I'll speak to Mr. Pokhriyal, who is a minister. I don't know whether he's a secondary school also.
That's what I told.
The syllabus should go down. There's no need to have such a huge syllabus.
Yes, sir. That's what I told, that we are curating the syllabus. And by end of June, the syllabus will come. It is not only being kept in mind that the student should not be overburdened because of paucity of time. We are also taking care that the NEET exams and JEE exams should also, NTA should be informed the same syllabus, so that when the 2021 examinations take place, all those factors should be kept in mind.
Okay, so I understand. So maybe I request we will have three more speakers. Pallavi Gupta will speak with some slide sharing. Later on, Dr. Yashpal Sharma and Mr. Barthwal will have to wait for some time because he's our friend. I can take liberty with him to speak a little later. So, and then Dr. Hari Sharma from Nederland will be speaking from Holland, telling about what are the aspects of education from France, and then Dr. Yashpal Sharma. So may I take Pallavi just to find her, where is she? And she is an assistant professor in start.
Can you give share screen permission?
No, you have to do yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, I cannot see you. Where are you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Good evening, everyone. I am Pallavi Gupta. I am an assistant professor in Amity University and associated with the strategic empowerment. So first of all, I would like to thank you, Dr. Vivek Gupta, who creating a platform to share ideas and solution over education, impact on education. So, having an experience of 10 years in education industry, I would like to share a few things about the impact on education, impact of COVID-19 on education system, teaching learning process. So can you permit? Hello?
You have already, you can share the screen yourself.
Okay, thank you.
You have a system in the Zoom. Just press the share screen, you'll get it.
Okay.
Are you able to do it? No.
No, I can't.
So I'm making you co-host and then you can do it.
Okay.
I think now you can do it. Just check. Okay. Now we can see the slides.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay, everyone can see the slides?
Perfect, perfect. Loud and clear and very visible. Okay, please go ahead.
Okay, let's see first, let's see the current situation of the COVID-19. In the current scenario, like 1.6 billion children are affected by the April of 2020, and 191 countries had shut down all their primary school, affecting almost 1.6 billion children. Secondly, the shift to remote learning has been uneven. Some systems were able to train teachers, roll out remote learning, and put in the place student support services in less than a week. Like, for example, my child is in Amity school, so I have an experience. Amity school is a very, Amity is a rollout learning system within a week. And there are many schools, when he, hello, yeah, am I audible?
Yeah, perfect.
Okay, there are many schools which are shut with no learning, Others are still struggling, constrained by lack of access to technology or expertise. The disparity is obviously true between countries. It is also true within them. So there are, according to the McKinsey school framework, actually. So first is resolve. Focus on the immediate health threat that COVID-19 poses to student, teacher, staff, and the community. Second is resilience. Educators address near-term challenges such as setting up remote learning and supporting vulnerable students. Third is return is about reopening school and ensuring remediation for lost learning. And the fourth is the reimagine. Leaders think what the next normal could be like and how education system could reinvent themselves. And the fifth is the reform. Educators has to be considered education priorities in light of lesson learned. So in this current scenario, we have to focus last three R's. That is return, reimagine, and reform. Because on the first two R's, we can do learning and teaching process, right? So next is the what will be the two top priorities for school system. First is maintaining health and safety of student, staff, and the community and staff. That Renu ma'am is saying, and the Vandana ma'am is saying, all the children have come like 50% in one day coming, and other day the next 50%. The social distancing is maintained like that way. And the other is maximum student learning through learning and thriving. So there are three challenges, like delivering quality instruction is clearly a challenge in current circumstances. Challenge, however, varies widely. So first, that technology advanced countries and schools have been able to roll out synchronous and asynchronous learning. So technology advancement must be there. Less developed ones are using a combination of television, radio, paper packers, and cell phones. Some are struggling to deliver even that, and their students will have considerable to do. So, like in many rural and urban areas, even in Delhi and in states like UP in India, schools are permanently shut down. There are students who struggle a lot, because in urban areas, in remote areas, in urban areas, like, there are many students, no education is there, or all schools are shut totally. So the impact right now is to get remote learning to as many students as possible. In districts where resources, expertise, and leadership are available, it is possible at least to get started 1 or 2 weeks, and then to create assets to foster continuous improvement, and there the role of NGO in India a lot. So maximizing student learning and thriving access to devices. First is access to devices and internet connectivity is uneven in affluent districts. In developed systems, addressing that is a critical first step to ensure equity. For example, in France, France is lending devices and providing printed assignment to students who don't have access to computer or the internet. For example, China is offering mobile data package and telecom subsidiaries. It has also reposed segment of the state-run television channels to air lesson plans for K-12 education in remote region. So like that, India has to be developed this type of system incoming scenario. Second is grading. Another vexing issue is what to do about assessments and grading. Given that the end of term examination have been largely cancelled for students struggling with the prerequisite of remote learning, including just finding a quiet place to study, figuring out what constitutes a fair grading system will not be easy. Systems are experimenting with a variety of options. For example, United Kingdom has announced that students will get calculated grades based on their prior assignment, teacher assignment, and attendance. Secondly, for example, United States exempt states from federal testing requirements for the rest of their academic year. Australia, the states of New South Wales, is proceeding with its higher school certification, but is giving greater flexibility to school to decide how assessments are carried out. So in India, India has to be give grades in different like all other countries, right? So how the question arises, how artificial intelligence and technology help school teachers in the present scenario? Teachers being occupied 50 hours of working time week of teacher week 50 times per week, and the in which 49% of time is in direct interaction with students. Only 49%. Rest of the time, teacher prepared the slides, evaluation and feedback, professional development, administration. So teacher, with the help of artificial intelligence, teacher can reduce the timing of reduce the time preparation, evaluation, administration, and increase the time of student-teacher interaction. So in the last, I would leave with these three questions. When should school reopen? And for which segment of student and teacher should school reopen? And what health and safety measures should school adopt on reopening? So thank you very much for everyone for sharing my thoughts. Okay, thank you very much everyone for sharing. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, I think it was a very nice presentation, and you have worked hard to show what international schools are doing and so what we have to do. I think you have to stop sharing the slides. You see, always stop sharing the slide. Huh? So how to take other people now?
Yeah.
Yes, okay. Okay, so it was a good presentation, and you keep stay, and maybe there are some questions regarding this from other people. Let me talk to Mr. Barthwal now, and then Dr. Yashpal Sharma will give his final or pre-final comments, and then we have some more speakers. If somebody wants to speak in between, they can raise their hands. I am ready to invite anybody. So Mr. Barthwal, thank you Pallaviji. It was a very nice talk and good presentation and good slides made, and you gave an overall view of the whole world, how people are going to cope up with this problem, and the children should not suffer. We don't want children to get infected in the school, and that will be a big menace. And in fact, we have to be very, very careful to start the whole system to come back to track. It is not easy for the school system. That is why we have chosen this topic, because even the children are vulnerable, and we have to be very, very sure. And nobody would like to send the children to school, or should be online continue, or we have to start working. It's not an easy thing to do. So may I invite my friend Mr. Barthwal, Vinod Barthwal, who is a principal of the Jasola Vihar DAV school, and he's running a big school, and a huge number of people, both middle class and higher class students, are coming. And in fact, we are very happy that they have a limited fee structure, so anybody can afford. Mr. Barthwal, please go ahead. I think there's something wrong in the video.
Wonderful opportunity, and to meet all the luminaries And the topic for today, that is about the COVID-19, the impact on the school education. So, maximum the inputs, the principals and other speakers they have given, but still I would like
can you, sorry to interrupt you. Can you little tilt your mobile, or you are talking from the laptop? Yeah, this better.
Mobile.
I can see your tie also. I want to see which color of tie you are wearing. So little more.
Yes.
Okay.
So this is a webinar, today's impact on the COVID-19 in the school education. So first is about this COVID virus, and about the virus, first Dr. Sava has told that viruses, these are non-living in the environment, and when they enter the host facility, then they multiply inside, and then the person is affected. And like this virus that is like formidable with touch, etc., it is affecting, and entire world is suffering about the schools, etc. 90% children are at home, schools are shut all over the world, and the same scenario is here in India as well. So what we have done during this lockdown period in our school, and then after that, what is our future program, that I would like to inform to each one of you. First is adopting technology. Like the students and the teachers, they have used the technology, and that is for the first time they have done. Normally, like this, the technology, etc., or the distance learning that is in the college and the universities, etc., or the like remote distant learning, etc. But now it is completely started at the school level. Now in schools, we find that students are using mainly Zoom, then Microsoft Teams, then the Google app. Through these, they're working. And there are issues coming. One is sometimes the internet connectivity issue comes, and sometimes the children, they are posting or muting and unmuting, these type of issues also come, and that affects the studies. So initially there were these type of issues coming. Gradually the teachers have overcome all these problems, and then the classes were going on smoothly. Then other is it was a learning experience for both students as well as teacher, because earlier they have never done all these. Then how this teaching is different from the normal school working, that is when the children, they go to school, then they have, as Mr. Agarwal informed, when they come to the school, they have all periods, like the practical periods are there, and then the game periods. Especially the children, they wait for the games period in the school, and then the music, then dance, then the number of activities, these are held. So these all activities are not there because the children are at home. Though we are giving the CCA activities online, they are doing, and then they are posting here in the school, but still that thing is not there. The children are isolated, and then they are missing their friends. They are missing the teachers, and some students, they are connected to some teachers to whom they like. So their social, then emotional, and then the physical development, I feel that is affected. About the teachers, Abraham Lincoln said that if you have 6 hours to chop down a tree, and I will spend the first 4 hours to sharpen the X. So in the same manner, the teachers, they utilize 80% of time in programming and planning, and then after that 20% time in the execution. This is what the teachers have been doing. Many students face challenges in the home learning and the online teaching. Like there are EWS students, economically weaker students, and they don't have even the mobile. So for that, we are giving them the assignments, etc., and that also delivering assignments.
spotlight now?
Delivering the assignment, that is also difficult, and I feel that the government intervention is required here, that they should provide like through TV or through radio, etc., some program for the children, those who can't afford. Teachers have started this Zoom, Microsoft Team, Google Classroom, and then after the class, students are after the lockdown, initially the children were not giving any type of complaint, but now they say that there are a number of things like neck pain issue, back pain, physical and mental stress. These type of issues are reported from the children. Then sometimes the parents are sitting with the students, and the parents are sitting with the students, then they are criticizing the teacher, or sometimes the teacher is also hesitant. So the delivering of the content that is affected in this manner. Then poor audio visibility, then connectivity, then some students, they have gone to the villages, the migration of the students to the village, and again there they have the connectivity issue, then how they'll overcome the problems. Then online teaching and the learning is a challenge, and nowadays, but it is the future and need of our across the globe, for which we must be prepared. I think this is all, and as the HRD ministry and the CBSE, they are planning for board exams. Like board exams will be from 1st to 15th of November. During that time, they have given that distancing, social distancing norm has to be followed. There will be 12 children in a room, and all the norms like making circle, etc., then whatever precautions. So these type of precautions will be there for the students, as other principals have pointed out, that there will be maybe 50% of the children will come later, or 33% of the children will come. So for that, we have to make all the arrangements, like safety and all precautionary measures in the school, so that the parents are also feel secure that their children are safe and they are in safe hands. Thank you very much
Mr. Barthwal, for giving the insight what you are planning. And you said the examination will be held in May, in November,
and July. Board exams, leftover exams will be in the July, 1st to 15th of July only.
So 1st to 15th of July. So okay, so I think it was a very nice illuminating talk, and now I request our friend Mr. Barthwal, please stay back, and I request Mr. Yashpal Sharma, who is the professor and head of cardiology in PGI Chandigarh and our collaborator of Indo-European course, to please give some insight. We don't want cardiology, but as a parent, as a social person, we want what you think about the students when they are going to the school, how apprehensive anybody will be. You can introduce yourself and you start speaking. Mr. Dr. Yashpal Sharma, please.
Thank you, Dr. Gupta. Good evening to everybody. In fact, very illuminating lectures by all. Very impressive. As you know, Dr. Gupta, we were sharing earlier our clinical experience with the in the webinar with the overseas doctors. And we were sharing our difficulties, challenges, other things, patient-wise. So we communicated the therapeutic part of our experience in PGI, that depending upon our experience of COVID-1, MERS, and H1N1, we could have a better outcome in our cardiac patients, which we communicated there. And I think that helped a bit to decrease the mortality in US and otherwise, because you know Lytic and 2B3A are now being used very sparingly. So as we were discussing the modality, now our this is next phase for students, for teachers, for others in the society. One recently that next 1 or 2 months will decide. But as already said, that school will be opening somewhere. School will be opening somewhere in September, August, September. So we should get prepared for that. Definitely, the teachers are giving online classes. Students are reading a lot new things as we are giving telecardiology, teleconferencing. Very good experience we are getting, and patients are getting satisfied. In fact, some of the patients in far off distances, lay-like, when they get connected, they were coming to PGI in 7-10 days, and now they are getting consultation within 2 hours. So some aspects are good also for students, but just because the teachers are also very important, because they are all in age group, a different age group. So I will start from teachers, because they are the gurus of all students. And first of all, that gurus are always respected. So basically, their health is very, very important. And some of you know, as the age advances, some are hypertensive, some are diabetic, so many, because all are not healthy. For all precautions to be taken is the most important, because if we exert too much during this period, and you know, pandemic is there, some 80-90% they remain asymptomatic. But if we exert too much, the chances of getting it prolonged and becoming secondarily infected or prolonged viremia is always there, which we always use to read post-viral fatigue syndrome. So 1991, when I was a DM student, we read a lot of North Clinics of America regarding viral diseases. So basically, virals, these tests were not being done in our country. Now this test, when these are being done, future we will be very careful about all viral diseases. But at this time, teachers should have all precautions regarding their blood pressure control, their diabetic control, their activity, their nutrition, their sleep, their this one teaching. So basically, this is an integrated. Now I'll come to the students, because students are at now reading in the, you are giving lectures, they are enjoying the lecture, they are studying very hard, content-based to competence-based, because there will be so much innovations, there are new ideas. I think MHRD and CBSE, they would evolve some structure that innovation should start, because from the student college level, they should have some innovations which should get protected by IPR. Their name should come, teacher's name should come. Because India is evolving, we should have the time for this. In fact, the small thing sometimes is so important that you cannot think that it is such a useful. We were discussing mask. I was discussing with Dr. Gupta that if we would have worn mask from the beginning, the pandemic lockdown should have been shorter. And similarly, I was just discussing for the students that even low cost 5 to 10 rupees, this one face shield with the transparency which everybody is writing, they, if they start wearing like this, it will be costing just 5 rupees with Velroth and just small connection here and small foam. So this is such a thing which will help in preventing the infection from one person to another in crowded places, while going for a walk, in schools, everywhere. So this will act as a with the legal community and that the vaccine work will do, just like mask, these barriers, your activity. One thing is very important for students and for everybody. By wearing a mask, one should not exert too much. This is a time of pandemic. We have to live intelligently. We have to pass through this stage. We have to win over this situation, because battle is there. This war is going on with the corona. So if we win, we will be there. But if we lose, then we will not be the one winner. So for that, every small action of ours should be very intelligent. Regarding our, if we start running with a mask. And if we remove the mask, then it's also harmful. We will catch the infection. While running, we will give aerosol to the others. So infection will spread. While this one, activity, reducing the activity, not running, jogging, doing normal pace walk, not get exerted or breathlessness. So 60% of the walk should be there when they were doing. So this is such important. We gave in the advisory and this became so much viral all over the world because this is simple oxygen. 15-12% this mask are reducing, 10-12%. If we exert, demand supply mismatch and type 2, arrhythmia, sudden cardiac death, other problem can occur, even in the asymptomatic normal people also. So these sort of activities should be told to the students when you are delivering lecture regarding their diet. They should have nutritious diet, high calorie, means protein should be more, and iron should be more, their immunity should be more. So these things are very, very important. We doctors are also advising, but sometimes the students listen to their teachers very well because they are so, this one student-teacher interaction is there as we have doctor-patient faith. So these small sort of activities, you should prepare them from the now onwards so that they are well prepared. And regarding, I think, social distancing and other things, as you already said that one-third you call, maybe alternate day, similarly as we are calling, planning our patients by appointment in the OPD, 10-20 patients, this one per doctor, and that also very social distancing, in and out different. So similar sort of in the schools, where there is no this one mixing of so many students like that, exit, enter, and social distancing, diet, they should not run in the school. Their sports and everything should be very different way. So at any stage, in that way, our plan should be to save the children as well as teachers' atmosphere life. So that will be possible. Basically, the things are not difficult. There are small things which get tuning only. Regarding this online teaching, if these lectures are also recorded, they listen many times as in the YouTube or something. So a lot of education will be so high in the coming days that you will see that it will surpass any developed country in the world, what I feel, with innovation and other things. Because our biology field, we are thinking that so much rush used to be in PD. Now with the OPD teleconferencing, we were first to start in cardiology. Now whole this PDI, otherwise also it started. We started just after the lock. Then we told our cardiac patients that cardiac patients who have undergone stenting or on heart failure treatment are taking antiplatelet, they should ensure that medicine they should take and blood pressure should take control. And luckily, our endothelial dysfunction flow, which we did from 2002 onwards in COVID-1 era, that theory came out to be same as this COVID-2, because there is an endothelial dysfunction, flow, coronary thrombosis, small vessel thrombosis in the pulmonary artery, other vessel thrombosis. So with that theory, we could give lytic and 2B3A inhibitor, nicorandil. So majority of the patients, they survived, as we presented in various national and international conferences at various levels, earlier also, published also. So basically, the thing is, we should not spread this infection. Hospitals should not come, patients should not come too many at a time. If they get scattered over this one, over 2 years, small number of patients, they will be saved. So our is to increase at the every level, at society level, school level, gathering level, shopping level, airport level, other level, because you know that doctors are becoming victim, because doctors, this aerosol is very high. When they operate on any, the patient, it is always not safe for the patient, COVID positive patient, if he undergoes surgery. And if he get mixed with the COVID positive negative, then also there is a problem that infection spreads very fast. So the thing is, intelligently, how to decrease the patient's load, make their better so that everybody heals, not go into that stage, and not so many patients come to the hospital. And hospital also, because after even they become negative, shedding rate remains. So 6 weeks, how to manage those? So these are very small things, because when we have to win the war, we have to act two step ahead. We have given one proposal to His Excellency Governor Sahab also regarding ivermectin in a society where this is too much. The disease is very high, hot spots. Similarly, this ivermectin drug got the Nobel Prize. I think this was for filariasis being used in veterinary very high dose, veterinary very for the very long time and has minimal side effect. It is an anti-worm drug. It decreases the worms also. If we decrease the worms and decrease the corona also, this is also used for lice and lice, etc. In veterinary. So thing is, such a small thing, because doctors are working very day and night. Mm-hmm. First was for patients. Now patients, they are saving. Now it is for society and prevention also. So in a way, it will be very useful. From time to time, I think with Dr. Gupta, we will be discussing and making some SOP guidelines, communicating at various levels, MHRD, others. This will be useful so that all over the globe, every child, every teacher, every citizen of society, every healthcare worker, every legal, political, bureaucrat, every life is safe at every place. Yeah. Regarding air conditioning, everything. So I think with this, I will, because so many other speakers, I will just stop. And thank you, Dr. Gupta. I hope that these few words will be useful for everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Yashpal. Actually, what you are talking is that we have to find some repurposed medicine, number one. Unless we have vaccine, we are not safe. This is very sure. Children are equally vulnerable. This is also sure. Earlier, it was thought that less than 10-year-old child have a higher immunity, but we have seen 25-year-old, 20-year-old, 18-year-old children, as well as lower age group also getting affected. So, as you told, ivermectin, I just want to, as I told you in my presentation also, that this is something like anti-protozoal medicine, and this requires to be tested in human being. US has already started. It is having some toxicity, but we'll see, and later on, that means we have to find one medicine where you take a tablet and you are safe for 1 week. That what hydroxychloroquine is doing it. But as of now, hydroxychloroquine is still not advisable by Indian Council of Medical Research for routine use. But I extend myself, those who are going out of houses very frequently, like policemen, like bureaucrat, like police, like office worker, they may be, we have to extend the guidelines to those extent. Okay, so coming back to the presenters, now I request a doc, thank you, Dr. Yashpal, please stay back and we'll have some music on the end. So I will request Dr. Hari Sharma from Nederland to please highlight, give some highlights regarding what's going on in education part. Your children have gone and brought up, being born and brought up in Holland, and you have seen the education system is far different in Europe as compared to India. There is much less stress and there is not many too many examinations. So what's going on as of now today in Nederland? Dr. Hari Sharma, please. Can you hear me, Dr. Hari Sharma? Hello? Dr. Sharma, he was here, I was live just now. Okay, I will, you are visible very well. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Hello.
So I want to highlight today, you are a scientist, you have been working in India before, you have lived all your life in Holland now, in Netherlands. In Rotterdam, I visited your house and you've been working in Amsterdam. I want to give you a small insight into the education system, that what you have been earlier and what is today.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Gupta. It's lovely. I have been hearing to some of the people from the high school, primary schools and all those level, and also Dr. Yashpal Sharmaji from PGI. I think he's from PGI, right?
Yes. Yeah.
So, a lot many things I heard. Obviously, it is really hard to compare Netherlands and India in relation to any education, the basic, we call the basic school, the primary school, or secondary school, or even the universities. We are open, actually, from middle of May. All the primary schools have been working fully. The children were going to the schools. And now, from 1st of June or 2nd of June, there will be complete opening. Means that all the schools, primary and secondary, would be opening. Only thing is that the strict measures, which are used by the public. So it's called the intellectual lockdown here. Everybody follows, 99.9% people follow the rules, the regulations. And when they are in the school, so only 50% of the class strength was there. And then they have, again, for the university level, they will have, or the secondary level, they will have also 50% strength, so that they can maintain 1.5 meter distance. So far, we do not use masks anywhere except in the public, like transportation. So when we are using the buses and trains and tram running for a special services, means that the people, those who are going to the work, they are using strictly those public transportation. There, everybody must use the mask, because the distance of 1.5 meter cannot be maintained. But rest everywhere, walking on the street, going for shopping, everywhere 1.5 meter distance is maintained. Even in the schools, the teacher, the children, everybody is maintaining that way of life, and then it's going on fine. We have done relatively well over the period of past several weeks. And for the last, I would say, 3 weeks, our curve is on decline. So today we had only the death of 8 reported. Yesterday, some 17 and 13, you know, that kind of thing. So from several hundred to, we have come to the number in 10. So by using all these measures, and there is a sanitizers are used before entering the place, and it is maintained, the distance is maintained. And if someone is having any symptoms, they are being asked to stay back at home, not to go to the work or school or anywhere. The primary, as you know, that the children of less than, you know, 7, 8, or 10 years of age, they must have got virus, but they do not show any symptoms. And that is really the recent study, and you know, people were observing it for a while. Therefore, these primary schools were open first on 11th of May in our country. And as you know, Sweden never shut down, you know, any school or any place. They used some measures, but they did not really shut down those primary schools even at all. Obviously, people are complaining that they should have really done a nice, you know, evaluation of the entire thing, which we are lacking some data from them. But nevertheless, here in the other part of Europe, it is being developed. So coming back to the way things are happening, the distance education, giving lectures, like we are giving our lectures on using the Microsoft team every day. The number will become differently. So 50% children or students will come to the university, and 50% will listen the lectures online. So the same lecture will be in the class, and then being streamed to the student, those who are not able to join. And this way, slowly it's opening up, and we hope, and the exams were going on. We conducted exams, and things are relatively normal here. The businesses are open, and the restaurant, the places where of much crowd are not yet open. So like in June, they are planning to open the museums, they are planning to open restaurants and other places, but maintaining all the norms. So there will be 50% or even less than that will be the occupancy of those places. Even to go to a particular museum, not a huge crowd cannot go. So proper booking, proper number, so much time, everything is very well recorded. Everywhere are the cameras, everywhere is the kind of control. It's a very, we cannot compare India. It's a very small country of 18 million, even less than Delhi, the population. But everything is, kind of internet or the systems are available everywhere. So 99.9% is this possibility to do the distance education. Obviously, a lot of inventions are coming up, as I heard from others. From your colleagues that a lot of new technologies being developed and it's good. It's really good. And here also in Holland, a lot of innovative ideas, innovative things are coming up. And I think the app by which Government of India is trying to trace the COVID people, similar kind of apps are being developed with much security and with much privacy regulations here as well in Netherlands. And I think that's how we have to live with the virus. Virus will not go away just like that. Virus will be there. We have to, adapt to live with this situation and just make best of it.
Just interview you. What is the cause you felt that numbers of deaths have gone down, even the number of infection has gone down? Number of people who are getting infected per day.
Yes, everything.
What do you think? Is virus killing itself? Virus is going because we have no medicine, we have no vaccine, we have no prevention.
Right.
So what is the reason why Holland is showing, or Nederland is showing a decline in the number, while there was a news today that the heat will kill and you're not heated as India. So what is the reason? What do you think personally, the numbers have gone down, or they have stopped testing, or they've reduced the testing, or what it is?
So, as you know, that the virus, above 50 degree virus is killed. But even the strong heat, like the strong sun, which has the UV rays, the strong sun plus higher temperature will kill the virus. So, that would, the higher temperature and the straight UV rays would definitely decrease the load
of virus. How it's a very good news that Holland, the numbers are going down, and I don't know what about France and Germany. So
yeah, it is under control. Yeah,
what is the reason? Really, really. Is it social distancing alone, or is it a barrier, or is it that people are not infecting other people? Is that the reason?
Everything. So how it is looked at, like the herd immunity which we talked about earlier. So it's a combination of herd immunity and restriction. So the people above 60 years or 65 years of age, those guys are much careful. And also the youngsters are very careful with them. They would not go closer to them when they are walking or, anything which is requiring the protection of the elderly people.
No mask.
Is being, and the youngsters, they have got or are being in the process of getting virus, and they are coming out of it. And because a lot of people, those who are having severe situation, going to the hospital, but asymptomatic people, they are just there, and they have not been tested even in any part of the world. I mean, in Holland or any Europe, they have not been tested. They got the virus, they got the immunity, and that's it. We don't know. There is no control. There is no guarantee. So therefore, it's a combination. The people, those who are, the workers in the hospital are being tested. The nurses are being tested. Or the people, those who have developed the symptoms and immediately going to the hospital or to the, separate organization called KKD, GGD, they are being tested.
I think, thank you very much. It's a very good system. We know that we can really take over this virus if we follow the exactly strict norms which is being there.
It's a combination. It's a combination. So the elderly people have to be careful.
We were speaking to Dr. Fausto Pinto in the last webinar, who is the president-elect of World Heart Federation. He was absolutely against the herd immunity, considering, okay, it doesn't matter, but we have to be, we have to live with the virus, so we have to find the ways out. So finally,
It's not really the herd immunity which I talked about. It's a combination. You know, the people, those who are 60 plus, you can't ask them to go for herd immunity. So everybody has to be careful. The government, the health workers, they all have to be careful for the elderly people, those who have a compromised immune system. So that's how, you know, combination, so that you are not really overloaded in the hospital.
Finally, I would like to find out anybody else who is there, video live, would like to make a final comment, or then otherwise I will request, before we have a concluding remark, we'll have one or two songs more. Anybody else would like to comment who is listening to me, if they can put their video on or audio on and they can speak one or 2 minutes. If somebody else, okay. So there are a few questions actually. Which have come into the chat, and let me just read out. There are one or two. There are a lot of comments, but the questions. Let me see if there are questions there. Yeah, somebody asked that why if Bangladesh can do a successful using ivermectin and doxycycline. Dr. Yashpal Sharma would like to answer. Somebody has asked that if Bangladesh has one hospital and Bangladesh has used ivermectin and doxycycline combination, and so why we have not done it, number one. And so this is the question which has come from somewhere else.
Dr. Gupta, I just want to tell that we have made SOP and they are very clear now. Today we have finalized all those which should be at for various this one age group and hotspots. So ivermectin will be used very this one commonly in India, because every side effect will be online, everything online consultation is going on. This tele we will be having from all. Basically, the thing is we have to make this virus negative very fast. Regarding treatment, I'm telling you, we in PGI had two, three patients, children. They are coming with myocarditis, ejection fraction of 15-20%. We could raise it to 45-50 within 4-5 days, and that virus, I hope that 4-5 days after this it will become negative. We have not used ivermectin so far, but we will treat this, use it in therapeutic also, as in hotspots, wherever kids are there. So hopefully this drug will be used very, this is generic, very low cost drug.
What about, what is the ethics committee in PGI Chandigarh? If you want to start some trial, can you do yourself or you have to take permission from ICMR?
We have sent this one trial to ICMR, but that trial, our this cardiac shock, we have already taken approval.
Do you need permission from ICMR, or you can do yourself with the ethical committee of your PGI?
Dr. Gupta, if our trial already is going on registry, for acute cardiac shock, we had already approved that for any new drug, because this is a war-like situation, we have not to wait for this one. We have to send it. It should be online clearances. It should be within 72 hours.
I just wanted to know, what is the protocol in your PGI? Can you do it yourself without ICMR, just by the ethical committee of your hospital or institute?
No, the thing is we send it to the ethical committee. Ethical committee has to, this one, they will go very fast. But if some drug is being used otherwise, that is for new drug, because I'm a member of...
Okay, but is for the repurposed medicine, you don't need ICMR guideline. This is what I want to know.
Yeah, for hydrochloroquine and other, you do not need this one.
Not for hydrochloroquine. For example, for ivermectin, because this is not being tested in India as of now.
Ivermectin is being used many otherwise.
I'm talking of COVID.
The thing is, we have to have safety and everything data, and we communicate to the ethics committee and to the others also. Then I think we can use it. The thing is, if we cause any one mortality, there are 1,000 get infected. If we say make him negative within 4-5 days, there is no contamination. Our different is never.
So I think we have to conclude this webinar. We have had 2-3 songs I would like to hear from Mr. Jeswani before that. Thank you, Yashpal, for a very nice informative talk. And I think I'll take one final word from Madam Vandana Kapoor. She has been very informative. Would you like to say a final before we take up the, or we can go for the songs and then you conclude. That's better. Mr. Pankaj Jeswani, please come. One or two more songs and then we are really interested to hear something. And Dr. Mr. Aman will also conclude by one final comment from everybody before we conclude this webinar. Very interesting and very informative.
Thank you, Dr. Vivek. Awaaz aa rahi hai meri? Sir, meri awaaz aa rahi hai?
Perfect. Perfect. Please
yes,
go
sir,
ahead.
Thank you, sir. Main suna raha hu sunna ek sundar sa geet. Hum kai baar aapke saath jud chuke hain. Kishor ji ke bahut gaane gaaye hain. Maine aapko ye pasand hai. Is waqt mera mood jo ban raha hai, ek Mukesh ji ka song hai. Uske baad kuch Kishor ji ke sunaunga ek aadha. Jab bhi jitna time mil jayenge. Main pehle aapka dhanyawad karun. I'm very honored. Very grateful. Be connected with all of you. अपने मन की बात में भी कह देता हूँ गानों के जरिए. ये सुंदर सा नगमा बेहतरीन. ऑडिबल सर, ऑडिबल है म्यूजिक? ओके
दम दम डिगा डिगा मौसम भिगा भिगा दम दम डिगा डिगा मौसम भिगा भिगा तेरी अदा बहुत बहुत क्या बात है भाई तेरी अदा बहुत बहुत क्या बात है अखियां झुकी झुकी बातें रुकी रुकी अखियां झुकी झुकी आते रुकी रुकी देखो लुटेरा आज लुट गया हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह दम दम दिगा दिगा मौसम दिगा दिगा जिंदगी में तो गिरा मैं तो गिरा मैं तो गिरा हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह सनम हम माना गरीब है जी सनम सनम हम माना गरीब है नसीबा खोटा सही बंदा छोटा सही नसीबा खोटा सही बंदा छोटा सही दिलिए खजाना है प्यार का हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह दम दम दिगा दिगा मौसम भिगा भिगा पिंपिए मैं तो गिरा हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह हाय अल्लाह सूरत आपकी सुभान अल्लाह
ये ओरिजिनल ट्रैक था मेरे पास मुकेश जी का बच्चा को पसंद आया होगा गीत. थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू. अब एक किशोर जी का गीत जैसा चाहते हैं डॉक्टर साहब आपकी पसंद भी रहती है और यंगस्टर्स भी जो है मेरे साथ थी बहुत ही रोमांटिक और बहुत ही मीनिंगफुल और फीलिंग के साथ ये किशोर जी का नगमा है. मैं अक्सर मंचों पे गाता हूँ और उसकी फरमाइश आ जाती है कई मंचों पे लाइव शोज में तो ये मेरे साथ शेयर कीजिएगा. बहुत ही सुंदर नगमा है. फिल्म का नाम है कुदरत. विजय शर्मा जी पिछड़ाई था याद होगा बाबा की ये 70s की फिल्म है 80s अर्ली 80s की फिल्म है. आवाज ठीक है सर? लाउड तो नहीं है म्यूजिक? हाँ
हमें तुमसे प्यार कितना ये हम नहीं जानते मगर जी नहीं सकते तुम्हारे बिना हमें तुमसे प्यार कितना ये हम नहीं जानते मगर जी नहीं सकते तुम्हारे बिना हमें तुमसे प्यार तुम्हें कोई और देखे तो जलता है दिल बड़ी मुश्किलों से फिर संभलता है दिल क्या क्या जतन करते हैं तुम्हें क्या पता ये दिल बेकरार कितना ये हम नहीं जानते मगर जी नहीं सकते तुम्हारे बिना हमें तुमसे प्यार
Thank you very much, Pankaj ji. अगले गाने अगले वेबिनार में सुनेंगे. It was really lively क्योंकि इसके बाद थोड़ा सा we'll take a final comments from all the major speakers. So please, Mr. Aman Agarwal, just give a final one last comment. Schooling में हम लोगों को चिंता तो है ही है, लेकिन क्या हम लोग क्या हॉलैंड का मॉडल अपना सकते हैं या अभी हमको मास्क रखना पड़ेगा? Because we have more crowded, more number of people. Just one minute, please.
Yes, I think thank you, Dr. Gupta, to give me another chance to express my last views. I think after listening to everybody and my opinion, we need to take a positive stand. We have to take care of our emotional quotients. And we need to take the fact that we have to live with COVID. That particular thing has to come in our mind and we have to get this fear out of it. There are so many animals which live, you know, there have been so many dangerous animals which live all around us. Why can't we live with it? And we need to take these chances of going forward with it. If we have a positive bent of mind, I don't think this will really create that problem as we are seeing today. Certainly, certain norms which have been provided by medical fraternity like you, WHO and the government of India have to be taken into consideration. But I think education would be back on its sphere. It's only a question of time because the fear has got a little too supermounted. There are a large number of other diseases which are creating more catastrophes than even COVID per se. So, and the death rates are much higher in those cases than COVID as well. So, but we, as I said, let's get the emotional and the mental state of mind positive and keep that frame in mind that we need to keep a balanced life, balance between work and home, balance between digital and non-digital. And that's very important when it comes to students in specific, when they are looking at their growth, because we need to have them an appropriate approach. They need to have a social life, they need to have socio-cultural life, they need to have interaction with other students, with teachers, and so on and so forth, and going out on to play fields. I would like to close
We have to come back to work. Madam, would you like to have the final comments? Ki abhi aapko September mein school khulenge ya pehle khulenge kya hai?
Yes, doctor. सितंबर में अभी स्कूल खुलेंगे या नहीं खुलेंगे वो डिपेंड करेगा कि जुलाई तक हालात कैसे रहते हैं बट वी आर एम्पावरिंग आवर सेल्फ्स द एसओपीज विच आर बीइंग डिजाइन फॉर स्कूल्स आर इन कोलैबोरेशन विद आयुष मिनिस्ट्री विद एमएचआरडी एंड सीबीएसई सो वी आर ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट सेफ्टी मेजर्स फॉर द स्कूल्स बिकॉज बच्चे आइसोलेशन में पूरी तरह से नहीं रह सकते वो अक्टूबर से आए सितंबर से आए अगस्त से आए ये डिपेंड करेगा कि ये इंक्यूबेशन पीरियड कैसा जाता है बट डेफिनेटली द शो मस्ट गो ऑन सो चरैवेति चरैवेति, हम तो डीएवी में वैदिक संस्कारों की बात करते हैं और सारा वर्ल्ड हमारे आयुर्वेद और नेचुरोपैथी के लिए एप्रिसिएशन से देख भी रहा है. सो वी आई हैव लॉट ऑफ होप्स दैट थिंग्स विल इम्प्रूव ग्रेजुअली एंड वी विल अकस्टम आर वर्किंग एंड आर चिल्ड्रंस protocols according to Ayurveda, according to naturopathy also, and also we will take all the measures which are given by the Ministry of Home Affairs, then Swasth Mantralay. We are looking towards all of you. So I'm so grateful that you created this webinar on my request. And I'm very overwhelmed that all the speakers have given their precious views. And Netherlands model is really good and we are trying to follow it. We are working on it. So thank you very much for this enlightening session, sir.
Thank you very much. And thank you very much. All the speakers were very nice, especially Amar Agarwal, Harish Sharma, Jasola Sharma ji, Pallavi Gupta, yourself, Mr. Barthwal, and everybody works. So we were really happy to see, but there are a lot of questions remained unanswered today. We don't know if there was some medicine for the children which can be prophylactically used, then we will be much more safe. I think few research will come, and Dr. Yashpal says that there may be some prophylactic medicine will come, because no parent would like to put their child in a unsafe place. And this will be a big scare when the schools will open. This will be actually a big scare. And in fact, if I am parent, I will not be happy to send my son to a place where the other people can be infected because of the high mortality, 5%, 10%, you never know. I have seen few patients dying in sleep. I mean, you never know, because Dr. Yashpal will agree there are myocarditis which happens because of this virus. This is not an ordinary virus. So I would say that we have to panic, but we have to take precaution. We don't need to panic. But I want to tell you, that myocarditis, acute thrombosis, acute MI, all these things can be actually triggered by this particular virus. Patient may not have pneumonia. Patient can die of arrhythmias. So the things are remaining unanswered. I think this is the middle of May, 25th of May. We'll take another webinar in the end of June regarding the same topic with Aman and other people. And we may have somebody from HRD today. HRD Minister, Mr. Sanjay Dhotre, was supposed to join, but he had a meeting with the State HRD Minister, Government of India. But he had a meeting with group of ministers with Dharmendra Pradhan ji. Therefore, he said no. But then his PS was supposed to join. He was supposed to go with the minister. So all are busy in the evening time. And then earlier, I was thinking of taking Mr. Anurag Tripathi, who is a CBSC secretary, but he was also not available. So next time, we'll plan it a little more in advance. We can take maybe Mr. Pokhriyal will come himself, because he's a good friend of ours. He's a cabinetist, HRD minister. Sure. I'll try to invite him next time so that we can plan 1 week in advance. They can book the slot for us, and then we'll have more insights. So today we are finishing this webinar with the thought process that things will be brighter soon for our children. People have to go to school. Virtual education is not enough. I thank once again to all the panelists, all the speakers, once again to come and give the time to us. And this was going Facebook Live, also on Zoom recording, also on Facebook of Indians in Paris, which has more than 25,000. How many people have already seen? But this will be again going again and again into the Facebook Live. Mr. Aman, please try to, I will send you the recording. You can send to your people so that we can also further get enlightened and people can. And thank you, Mr. Pankaj Jeswani, for always available for the songs. And we are very thankful to you for this. Thank you very much. And thanks and good evening, good night. This is almost 2.5 hours. And we have to finish this webinar now in the interest of everybody. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Good night.